And we are in the home straight in your box seat as we've been promoing leading into this season of your program. A new segment, Double DZB. Yes, Dexter Dunn, Zach Butcher, as I mentioned before, two of the hottest properties in the game. Let's go first to Christchurch and to Dexter Dunn. These boys are going to be part of each and every week. Very good evening to you, Dexter, and looking forward to this segment of the show.
Yeah, good evening, Greg, and the other boys. Yeah, no, it's been a good build-up, and looking forward to seeing the viewers get to see a bit of me and Zach mucking around and, you know, trying our best anyway.
Yeah, we've got a few segments over the next few weeks that are going to be rather interesting, challenges between you two. What about in terms of the Premiership, already on 32 wins for the season, Dexter, ahead of anywhere you've been before? What's driving you? Six-time Premiership winner, what's the motivation for you these days?
Probably pay my mortgage, Greg, but last few seasons anyway, missed most of August with Breeders' Crown and then probably going on holiday, and I don't think I've really missed a meeting in August this year, so yeah, got off to a pretty good start, and but I just enjoy the people I drive for, the trainers and owners. They're just they're really good people, and it's just, you know, you get good pleasure out of managing to get winners for them. It's it is enjoyable.
All right, you're the king of the South Island, if you like. King amongst the young brigade in the north is Zach Butcher. Zach's joined us here in our Stanley Street studios. Geez, a hard act to follow. You might not be able to beat him in the Premiership race, but I reckon we kick things off here by changing it around. Doesn't ZB double D roll off the tongue a little bit better?
I think you did right, Greg. Dexter, definitely a little bit sweeter than the DDZB, so we'll go with that. First one to me.
All right. Quite sort of a start to the season for you. I think you're currently on 7 wins, but you don't get the opportunities numerically that Dexter does. So how have you found the first part of season 2014-15?
Probably start a little bit slow. Barry's team's just starting to get up and going now, and the travel's starting to go down to Manawatu and that, so if I head down there, it'll probably pick up a wee bit, but at the end of the day, sort of my seasons revolve around just getting as many winners as I can and keeping the owners and trainers happy. So, hey, whether it's 40 wins or 100 wins, as long as I'm winning races, I'm happy with that.
All right, looking pretty sharp in your new gear.
I know, I feel sharp too.
All right, let's get into the first of these challenges. And boy, this was one. Boys learning to dance. I thought it was going to be a rather big ask. Let's go and check out the action. Double DZB, they're used to handling delicate fillies on the racetrack. Let's check out how they handle them on the dance floor.
So Johan, it's on my shoulder blade.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. A little bit like this.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So I'm reading your heart, actually. Yeah. I'm reading this whole area to get my message, because I don't know what you're going
to
do.
Try to keep yourself straight without, like, dropping your shoulders.
Right. Change weight, change weight, change weight, go.
I'm getting the hang of this.
Now, try to start walking. Going forward.
Come, which way?
Yeah, doesn't going forward.
Okay, going forward. Right.
Yeah, so you go forward. Good. Keep going.
Well, Stefan, with 8 years as a professional dancer, you'd know exactly just how difficult it would be to learn the Argentine tango in 30 minutes.
Quite right. It's a big challenge. I mean, normally we say tango dancing takes a lifetime. And to do it in 30 minutes, good luck.
Lads, it's time to decide who gets to tango first, so let's have a bit of paper, scissors, rock.
Ready?
On three. One, two.
Paper, scissors, rock.
Thank you.
tango's been. Stefan, how did the boys go, starting with Dexter, who was first up?
I think they both did a really, really good job. For Dexter and Cecilia, I think they had a good energy between the couples, so they danced really, really well together. There were a few little stumbles in between, which is to be expected in after 30 minutes. Musicality was pretty good, sometimes a little bit off the beat, but nothing too major, so they did a great job.
All right, that's Dexter. What about Zachary? Mm-hmm.
With Zach, I think the moves that you did were a little bit more complex than what Dexter and Cecilia did. Sometimes they went a little bit wrong, and I would have liked to have seen a little bit more connection between the couple. So maybe the chemistry wasn't quite as on the same level as with Dexter and Cecilia.
Okay, so ultimately we need to find a winner who took out the Argentinian Tango Challenge.
I'd say by a whisker it would be Dexter and Cecilia.
Cheers, mate.
Well done.
Thanks.
The first of our challenges. Well, who better to ask than a bloke who's just come back from that part of the world, Michael Guerin? What did you make of their first attempt at a tango?
Yeah, I went to a tango show in Argentina. I only got back this morning, and it didn't look exactly like that, Greg. Can we slow that footage down? Because they seem to be going very, very slow. But, mate, good on you for trying something different. Bit of a challenge, bit of fun, out of your comfort zone.
Yeah, it was a wee bit, actually. To be fair, after half an hour, I thought, I'm still not ready. Give me another 2 hours. It's actually pretty hard work, but me and Dex, we both did pretty well, I thought, especially from what the coach said. And at the end of the day, it was all a bit of good fun and a bit of a laugh.
Mate, you're a pretty competitive guy. I mean, obviously, with your mates, Josh Dickey and Simon Lawson, those sort of boys. Do you even get competitive about that? Does there a little sting when you get beat? You sort of go,
Yeah, I'm probably as competitive as they come. I think everyone on set would have known that. But, yeah, I said to Dex after I shook his hand and gave him a wee smile, but deep down I was pretty dirty on it all.
Hey, Dexter, let's come to you and get your thoughts around the first of our challenges. 1-0 to you. Well, do you think you'll be doing any tangoing in the future?
Yeah, it's good to get off to a good start, Greg, and maybe give it another crack, but I think I've got a lot to learn. But it's good to beat Zach, and as Zach was saying, very, very dirty when he loses.
Yeah, all right, let's get back to something both of you know a little bit more about, and that is the harness racing game. We want to go back to Addington Friday night. There are a few short price favourites there, Dexter, and one of those was Cody Singer. Talk us through this, because he's clearly got some head issues at this stage, to be fair to say.
Yeah, that's right, Greg. He's one of those horses, the ability's there, but he's not a bad horse at home. He just gets out off the place and he gets very, very excited and hypes himself up. And we've got him on the unruly from a stand, and I think we're going to get away all right and run just sort of back and stilled the star a little bit. And he got pretty fired up, and he can rear pretty high, I'll tell you that much. But once he's away, he's usually pretty good during the running, although we had a few steering difficulties towards the end of the race.
Yeah, we're going to roll those in, Dexter. So he settled a long way off them. Once he got around to the lead, punters were feeling a little bit better about life, but what about this point here? He's throwing his head around. This is about as aggressive as you get in a drive to wake him up.
Yeah, well, he just started got on the left rein, probably from the half on, and the further we got, the worse he got. And, you know, it wasn't probably till that last 100-150 metres I could actually drive him out, because he's just trying to fight me so hard in that left rein. But, you know, once I sort of gave him a tap with the whip, he sort of woke up and got going again. But like I said, he's really green and immature, but he has got the ability. So, you know, hopefully down the track and future times for him, he'll work at what it's all about and really show what he's worth.
All guns down there, Zach. That took a fair amount of skill, didn't it, from Dexter to get that guy home. They're not easy drives, are they?
Yeah, handled like a true professional anyway. Now, he does a good job, Dex, and the horse looks like he's got a bit of a future.
All right, it's a busy week ahead, of course, more so for Dexter than Zach. Action at Forbury Park on Thursday, into Addington on Friday, and then, of course, Sunday at Rangiora. Before we let you go, Dexter, we really need to get your best bet of the week. So where are you heading?
I'm going to start off early this week, Greg. I'm going to go to Forbury, a horse by the name of Starsky's Dream, having his first run back from last season. A really, really nice horse, got a lot of ability. His last start, ninth, was in the Southern Supremacy, so discard that. But, you know, he should be winning this race and going on pretty much further.
All right, that's Dexter's best of the week. What about for you, Zach? Just one driving opportunity. I think you're driving in half of the card anyway. What about settling on one for the people at home?
Yeah, keeping it pretty quiet this week, just got the 5 drives, but if I could go one for the people at home, it'd probably be a better race. Race about a month ago, but you know, it was a nice race, didn't go very quick, but I'm thinking Davey Carr will have it pretty right for Friday night, and if it is and thereabouts, it should be hard to roll.
All right, there's Zach and Dexter and their thoughts around their best drives for the week. We've also got Dave McCracken, who sponsors our McCracken Sportswear segment each and every week. He thinks Woodley DJ, who looks the leader in that race and has been in much better fields lately. Zach's with Better Race and Dexter with Starsky's Dream. We'll keep an eye on how the lads go, keep you informed as to how good of selectors they are. We know how good of drivers they are. What about our other two lads alongside us, starting with you, Craig Thompson? You've scrolled your way through the fields. What's the best bet of the week?
I'm going for a Dexter drive. It's not Starsky's Dream. Going Art Union. I thought Barrier won. I thought he, in a race, he looks like he's a leader. And Craig, I thought he was really good in winning last start. And I thought he could roll to the top from there. And with no second row, I thought he could dictate and get home. So I thought Art Union gets us off to a winning note on Thursday night.
All right, size stakes heat. It should be a cracking contest that. What about you, Michael?
Going with Zach, actually. I think Better Race was super fresh up, sitting parked. Not many horses at Alexandra Park sit park fresh up and stick on. Nice maiden field, that one. This isn't overly strong. I think it's a good each way bit. Davey Carr could be in for a good night. He's tended to have a lot of success at those Franklin meetings in the last 3 or 4 months.
All right. I'm pretty keen on one in the last race at Addington. I expect this horse to be in the sire stakes next Friday night, and it is Change Stride, the Haas to the 2008 winner of the New Zealand Cup, and Change Over. So there's a summary. Art Union for Craig Thompson. Better Race, Michael Guerin, going with the Zach Butcher drive in race number 4. And I think Change Stride will take out the last race at pretty short odds. Okay, we better summarise where we are racing throughout the country this week for Harness Racing. We'll be at Forbury Park, the first there underway Thursday night, 16 minutes past 5 o'clock. Addington and Auckland race concurrently, 5:47. The first at Addington, 5:57 for Alexandra Park. And Rangiora will be on Sunday, 12:30 the first there, and some pretty competitive betting markets for the Rangiora meeting. All right. Pretty close to an end to our first show of the box seat for this season. Let's start with you, Dexter. Thanks very much for taking the time out to spend some time with us, talk us through the challenges, etc. Looking forward to doing that each and every week. So you enjoy your racing week ahead.
Well done, Greg. It's been a pleasure to catch up with you.
All right, there he is, Dexter Dunn out of Christchurch. Zach Butcher got your way from Barry Purden's nice and early to rock in here, got you some good gears on, and your first sojourn into television, eh?
Yeah, no, it's been good fun. I come to it every week now. It seems like it's pretty easy work to do anyway. You boys get away with it good.
You're not wrong there. Michael Guerin, Craig Thompson. Michael, great to have you back in the country.
Thanks, bro.
And gee, we've got a really impressive 6 weeks ahead of us, haven't we?
I think if there's one tip going forward, it'd be Master Lavros will shorten for the Dominion Handicap by winning this Friday night. So I think he's going to be the big mover for the big races over the next week.
All right, Craig, for you, you'll be at Alexandra Park, of course. All eyes on Forbury, that size stakes heat. I think that's almost the My Sky race of the week.
Yeah, be looking forward to Thursday night, of course. League of Pick 6 as well, Greg. But Friday night, of course, Alexandra Park. Yeah, it's Franklin meeting. Of course, they've had their track resurfaced too, Greg, in the last 10 days there. John Dennett's done a great job. They had their first run there last Saturday. The workouts, and reportedly from all the drivers, the track's playing in really good order. So they'll get first use of it on race night this Friday night.
All right, certainly great to be back with Auckland Reactor, of course, standing at Alabar for 3,000-plus GST. This is your show. Why don't you contact us, tell us what you think, what you liked, what you didn't like. Email us, theboxseat@tab.co.nz. We'll certainly listen to what you've got to say, hopefully improve the show as we continue. You can contact us via Facebook, etc. as well. This has been your box seat. Enjoy the rest of your racing week.